Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of Bayonetta! When we last left off, we finished the prologue. So now we are in Chapter 1, The Angel's Metropolis. Let's get it started. Why does it always start in this screen?
So, I asked around, and some whale in Europe is trying to fence a huge rock on the black market. He calls it the right eye, saying it's part of some set called the Eyes of the World. Fits the bill of what you're after, don't it? Now, here's the funny bit. The stone passes around the halls of power for hundreds of years, vanishes, and then the black market goes white hot for the thing. But the seller wanted an arm and a leg for it, to the point no one could stomach the price. So back goes the stone, but not before everyone figures out where the guy is. You're gonna enjoy doing this one, I bet. I love sticking it to the rich. Of course, when you do, don't forget your old buddy Enzo stuck his neck out on this one. Slide me a few fuzzles out of the rich guy's pocket for my troubles, right? Anyways, you better get going before the trail gets cold. Off to the middle of nowhere. Paradise of Europe. Vigrid.
Oh. Did they let you bring those guns on the plane? Okay. Oh, I guess they're invisible people. Weird.
So, this is supposed to be paradise?
It is for somebody, I guess. Everybody's all ghosts. A resident of Vigrid. It may be a part of their religious doctrine, but everyone is wearing holy vestments. As long as I am in Purgarito, I won't be able to intervene in their affairs. But that also means that I should be able to get around this place without their interference either. Okay. Huh? Someone ran past me. It must be a ghost. Oh. Hot damn, you can get up some pretty high distances. Woo! Nailed it. Look at that. Up on top of the world over here. Alright. Well, let's go over there, I guess. There's a checkpoint. Hello. Oh, going on lockdown? Why'd it go on lockdown? The sphere embedded in the wall is emitting a wondrous light and resonant sound. Getting closer to it makes it glow brighter. It's as if it has some sort of ability to respond to a witch's power built in. Oh. I know. Oh, right. I gotta... Oh. Okay. Hi. Oh, to extend. Kabam! Nailed it. There's a hole in this this iron door for something to be inserted in. Oh, okay. Mend Mandgora root. Cured via crystallization, Mandgora root is a concocting compound used by witches. It is useless by itself. Oh, okay. Oh. Nailed it. Give me that. That is that is a ridiculously sized key. Oh shit. Oh, this turned into Kingdom Hearts all of a sudden. Okay. Yeah, I don't know why this turned into Kingdom Hearts, but cool, I guess. That's real cool. Okay. Ooh, yeah. Oh, platinum. Sweet. Is there a reason why camera, normal camera, inverted y-axis, off? Off? Yeah, is there like a reason it's inverted? A voyage towards the truth. Okay. I've been a journalist now for over 20 years, always aiming for the guiding light of truth, always pushing forward. I believe that communicating the truth is the core tenet of all journalism. Chasing it until my legs turn to rubber and the truth is burned into my retinas. Oh, well, that's just one of many books, I guess. Infernal Demons, the Hierarchy of... What? Do we have somebody in the Infernal... Madame Butterfly? Oh. A demon taking the form of a woman who left this world under unfortunate circumstances, only to be reincarnated in hell. Unlike her beautiful swallowtail butterfly-like appearance, this demon is particularly brutal, and her reputation is well known even among the denizens of Inferno. If a conjurer were to sign... Oh. Sign a contract and trade her soul, the demon would impart upon her enormous power and great wisdom. Oh, is there more to that guy's book? I didn't really check if I could scroll down. Oh, there is. But my journalistic career has hit an incredible wall, and I must confess that I've been crushed under the weight of the path I have traveled. It all began seeing beyond the stone-chiseled history of the old European city in Vigrid, and past the deep scars time had left behind. The passing of history has always been overseen by a select few, and they have left memories of a time stained with blood. This fact is integral in understanding the big picture, but it also causes one to hesitate before becoming involved in such a dark history. Treading down this path, I believe so firmly in means I cannot afford to lose faith in my convictions. It may also mean that my life is put into jeopardy. However, I hold deep within my heart the hope that even after my soul has left this body, as long as these notes, my proof of being are passed to the right man, future ages will also come to know the truth. They say that some things come at the cost of your life, but to me, truth is my life. In this age filled with lies and deception, I forever pray that truth will shine its light on the path of righteousness. Antonio Redgrave. Okay, well, thank you, Antonio. Tome of Umbrian Arts Rarities, The Hierarchy of Laguna. Alright, I have a lot of books and different equipment, it seems. Oh, you can add different guns or something? That's kind of nifty. Alright, well, let's get on out of here. It's a set of two crystal statues, but one is in pieces. It has been destroyed in an unnatural manner, as if in a fit of rage powered by a deeply held grudge. What? Wicked Weave. Wicked Weave technique uses your hair as a conduit to summon forth demonic entities. Connect these techniques to a punch or a kick combo for a devastating finish. What? Oh, you want me to do it now? Oh, damn. You good, fam? Got him. Ow, how? How'd you break my combo? Dang it. Well, I still got platinum. Cool beans. Is that good enough for you? Oh, I just kissed it to go away. And it is back. Uh, Lumen Sage and Umbra Witch. When their powers meet in a test of strength, the lightning released will be your test. If you wish to walk upon water, prove your mettle by dodging the lightning in a single hair's breadth. Okay. What? Oh. Ah. Hold on, do it again. Oh my god, that is real hard. Shit! I'm trying to do this, and it's like... Nailed it. Yeah! I did it. Ooh. Green Laurel. A laurel-shaped gem that contains vital essence in crystallized form. Revives one's vitality instantly when obtained. Oh. Bagam. Oh, made an elevator. Okay. Is that nothing? Do I just need to take the elevator? Going up? Uh-huh. A lift powered by magic. Humans would be unable to power this device. They are probably completely unaware of the ruins that lie beneath their feet. Okay. Well, they seem pretty okay with it so far. Which is, you know. Oh my god, my religious pets! I paid so much for them at the action. Oh, you can just break benches and shit. Well, that's it, nifty. And you get stuff for doing it. I get rewarded for being a destructive member of society. Is there anything in here? Oh, more of those. I have yet to run to a shopkeep, so I guess collecting as many as I can is probably a good idea right now. Until I find someone willing to trade. What's that on the ground? Baked gecko. Cured within a crystallized block, baked gecko is a concocting compound used by witches. It is useless by itself. Well, that's unfortunate. Uh-oh. That don't look good.
I knew it. This town's teeming with heaven's little helpers. It's making my buddies downstairs awfully nervous.
And your point is?
Some places in this world are closer to Paradiso or Inferno. The rat hole of the town you and I live in is close to both. But the Bigridians, it got a special air about them. They're closer to Paradiso than anyone should ever be. And that shit just plain creeps me out. I guess I'm gonna have to set up shop here and score me some halos. These stupid rings are worth a fortune back home. Since it seems you're spoiling for a fight, if you come across any of these, bring them to me, and I'll hook you up.
Oh, another one looking to line his pockets. I'm beginning to see why Enzo is so fond of you.
Real cute. But let's get one thing straight. Your fights are yours alone. I'm only here to watch my handiwork in action. So don't get any bright ideas about coming to me for help.
No, you get one thing straight. I'm not the slightest bit interested in the fact that you made these guns. If you get in my way, I will... How do the Americans put it? Oh yes, bust a cap in your ass.
Right on, baby. Right on.
Alrighty then. Well, that just happened. Well, can I get my halos back? Oh, good. You can tell it's a SEGA game because you have to collect rings. Unicorn horn. Cured via crystallization. Unicorn horn is a concocting compound used by witches. It's useless by itself. Why is it laying around here in town? No one will ever know the truth behind why there's just unicorn horns hanging out. Should let you signs. Purple butterfly. A butterfly-shaped gem that contains magical power in crystallization form. Revives one's magical power when obtained. Ooh, wait, what? It looks like a station gate, however it is sealed shut, maybe due to some sort of alarm system. The electronic sign above the door clashes with the old stone building it has been installed in. The building must be ancient ruins that were remodeled into a station. Unfortunate, indeed. Damn, what's this? A poster of some sort of event. The letters are similar to those used in magical seals. Oh. That explains why he says it's so close to Paradiso. Well, let's... What is this? Enter. Enter the gates of hell? Yes? Is that okay? I want to spend my rings.
You here for business or pleasure? Either way, I'll hook you up.
New hot! This symbol graces only the hottest of the hot items in my shop. If you're not sure what to go after, look for a face you can trust. Rodin, store manager. Wow, there's a lot of stuff. Rodin's treasures. What the hell? Oh, coming soon. I love chicks and the penguins. What? Techniques? Air dodge? And stiletto? Air dodge. Dodge an enemy attack while in midair. Oh, right. Midair, press right trigger. Slash into an opponent with incredible quickness and deliver a devastating thrust attack can also be performed in midair. Press left stick toward an enemy twice quickly. Press Y. Can also be executed by holding right bumper and pressing towards an opponent with the left stick and Y. That's a lot. Okay. It's stiletto. And what does it do? Slash into an opponent with incredible quickness. Okay. Actually, can I try before I buy? Ah. That's interesting. I guess you could follow up with some stuff on that. There's a lot of other ones that apparently I cannot get. Or can I get? Oh, I can get them, they're just not hot. Umbran Portal Kick. Open up a magical portal warping above your opponent's head and deliver a devastating kick. A wicked kick can also be summoned depleting your magic gauge. Press B while holding right trigger. What? Ha! Excuse me, what? Oh, damn. Okay with losing that stuff there? Look at this shit. That is. Aw. Trying to get her to do it when she was naked to see if it worked. Interesting. There's a lot of moves and stuff here. Okay, so what else we got? Accessories? Hot! Selene's Light. An ancient brace crafted by the Egyptian witch Cleopatra. When its wearer is attacked, witch time will be instantly triggered, expending magical power. As leader of the Egyptian practitioners of magic, Cleopatra developed this guard to assist those who had trouble grasping the finer points of witch time. Huh. Okay. Moon of Ma Kala. Brace is blessed by Shiva, the Indian goddess of destruction, said to have been crafted by the witch Yakasi. Yaksi? While serving the Vijayanagara Empire. Legend states the braces have the power to repel an enemy's attack. Yaksi was purported to have been invincible, as her mastery of this technique allowed her to nullify any attack no matter what the strength. What? How much are those braces? Damn. 200? Oh, they're grayed out because I can't afford them. That's why. Oh, beans, McGeans. Weapons are coming soon. Wow, I can only buy 2 Technox. Oh, I can't buy any Technox. Oh, yeah, I can. I could buy these Technox. Wait. I could buy all these Technox. So, the accessories I can't buy? No, the accessories I cannot buy. They are just a wee bit too much. Though that moon of Makala sounds awesome. Also, wow, you have a lot of... Oh, those are like lollipops. Okay. I was like, damn. All right. Interesting. Are they all braces? They're all braces. Okay. Dodges incoming danger. The beads will launch a magical counterstrike against the attacker. Interesting. Okay. I guess in terms of techniques, I should just get air dodge just to be safe. Because air dodge sounds like an attack worth keeping. Stiletto. It's not really that great. Oh, that was the Umbreon portal kit. Sorry. Stiletto is also really not that great, though. I will come back when I have demo money. Wait, why didn't I just take this portal to the place? Why did I have to pay the monies to do it? That's weird. Oh, all my stuff's back. Okay. Alright, let's go already! Oh, another book. Central Station. Well, I've never been here before. I've broken your guys' stuff. Central Station. What is... The history of the station is written here. It seems it was converted from an ancient temple. Oh. Very crafty. The Crystal Witch and Sage. Yep. Explain more. Within Vigrid City, there are a great many structures built long ago by two clans, the Umbra Witches and the Lumen Sages. Amongst them, all have a sun and moon duality, evidence of a peculiar outlook toward the universe. The witches representing the moon, and the sages representing the sun, burn into the fabric of the city in various ways. One of these structures, a pair of statues crafted from a high-quality crystal known as a Beltstun Crystallos, featured both a witch and a sage. The statues appear to hold some sort of special significance. According to ancient records, they were created to aid in the training of the art of overseeing time. A skill only the two clans were capable of practicing. That also served as the key to locking something away from public view should the clans feel the need for secrecy. However, the exact details of this art are unknown. Now the city, scarred by the tragic witch hunts of the past, has seen many of the statues depicting witches destroyed or heavily defaced. Even these beautiful crystal statues are unable to escape the calamitous fighting. That's unfortunate. Because I'm a hot mama, and I don't deserve that kind of treatment. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, butterflies. I'll just break your entire city. Why not? Ooh. Yeah, halos! Wait. Is this tree breakable? Nope. Just had to make sure I can destroy all of nature. There's a simple map posted. It appears the surrounding area is a historic neighborhood aimed at tourists. Well, perfect. I am a tourist. Theoretically. Ooh, what at? What at do? Ooh. Broken witch heart. A piece of a witch heart. Gathering four of these will increase the limit of your vitality. Yeah. Oh, yeah. What? Arcane bullet. Bullets used to play angel attack. One pack contains three bullets for use during the game. Oh. Well, that's nice. Huh. Okay. Well, that's cool and nifty. So there's stuff around the world I need to pay attention to. Because there might be witches' hots and bullets. Okay. I like the breakable stuff. I appreciate it. It reminds me of times long past of video games from olden days. But video games... Oh. Ooh, very pretty. Third sphere, Apollid Archangels. Oh boy. Oh no, not the angels. Wait, where are all these feathers come from? Oh my god, the glass is tipping with a gun. Just top tier. Can't beat that. Got him. Oh, my bad. I've had enough. Oh, you getting hit with your own goddamn staff. Ooh, right. Bam. There we go. Oh, take that. No. Ow. What? Pole dancing. Oh my god, that was amazing. Oh wait, no, it's these guys. Ah, there we go. Okay. Ow, what the fuck? Okay, I gotta get used to all these angel attacks. Alright. Trumpet? Whoa! God damn! These trumpets are mighty fine. Excuse me, what? Second sphere. Beloved powers. Oh, no. That's nasty looking. Whoa, that is a... that big weapon. Witch time, bitch! Ooh, right in the back of the face. Wait, what's going on? Ooh! Oh, I'm just like exposing his body. Ah! That still hurts me. That's not as good as I'd hope. Oh, there's some things over here. Oh god. Witch time, bitch! Ooh, got him! Oh! What? What the fuck is that? Oh shit! Well, damn. That girl. Oh, holy shit. That girl just summoned a giant face from hell and then ate a man with it. That is terrifying. What is this? Whoa, what? I have like some crazy strong gun. Troyus Marches Militarius. A golden LP featuring the crystallized voices of angels. Some sort of silhouette is drawn upon the surface. Ew, I don't want to watch a let's play from angels. Alright, wow, this is destroyed. I am so sorry, guys. It wasn't me, though. It was God. God did it. God hates you. Oh, I should read this. The area ahead is blocked off. It appears to be an effort to protect the deteriorated ruins. Really now? Deteriorated ruins? Blocked off? Not on Andrew's watch. No, sorry. Okay. I guess I could just do that while I'm holding my giant axe of doom. I'm assuming that is an impassable part, so I will not attempt it. Well, let's go in. Oh, well, we just kick it in. Nice! Pure platinum. Not that dirty platinum. I hate dirty platinum. Okay. I don't know how long I get to keep this axe. I kind of want to keep it as long as possible because it is a damn good axe. Look at all that stuff. Free stuff! Oh boy. I know, I saw that. Hold on. Broken witch heart! Yeah, got another one. Sorry, I'm not trying to look at her tits. I'm actually trying to see what's behind there. Oh shit! Girl, I'm just trying to check this stuff out for you. There you go. See, I'm trying to get stuff for you. Why you gotta be rude about it? Huh, you just can't jump from side to side. Well, that instantly broke it. Wow. Okay. Well, there's more stuff over here. So I have two witch's heart, which is awesome. Oh, and cutscene. Yeah, pretty standard ruins. Oh, we into past?
What are you doing? Let's go.
Okay. That witch be dead. Oh, I thought I dodged it. Woo! God damn! No. I was trying to do punches, but it wasn't letting me punch. Okay, this is not really working out besides shooting them. And while shooting is the funnest, I thought it was gonna be the heads, not the tail. Didn't even know you had a tail, honestly, to be honest with you. Yeah, witch time. Oh, I broke it before it got here. Okay. Oh, nailed it. That's kind of a boring boss fight. Maybe there's a better way to do that and I wasn't doing it. Wait, what? Excuse me? The mouth talks? Huh. That's terrifying. In its own way. Oh, whoa. I got a gold medal. Not as good. Probably because I got hit a couple of times. I was not ready. I'll be honest with you. Was not ready for that. Startled me. Witch's Brew. Detail this to me, please. I've discovered the existence of something called alchemy. It is a deconstruction, combination, and reconstruction of everything. Metal, flesh, even spirit. If one understands the logic of the age, alchemy is a prime example of the era in which it was developed. Although lesser known is the fact that alchemy is the offshoot of the witch's secret art of concoction. Concoction was only practiced by the Umbra Witch clan, and the materials, amounts, and methods used were never shared outside the clan's inner circle. However, the chaos of the witch hunts, some details were said to have slipped out, including knowledge of the primary mixing compounds, baked gecko, unicorn horn, and mandrago root. Also hidden was the role in controlling defense, offense, and vitality. It has been discovered that correctly combining these items may result in a creation of various useful compounds. These materials are obviously no longer in existence, and even if they still existed, outside of being a member of the Witch Clan, one would have to take out a contract with the dweller of the Netherworld to obtain these rare items. In case of emergency, the witches place these materials within Purgarito, a realm caught between the Trinity of Realities, in which the items are said to still remain. When creating a concoction, the correct procedures, amounts, and combinations are absolutely essential, and the art is not for the inexperienced. Okay, good to know. Good to know. Oh, well, we just have the crafting availability now. Oh, I know what the crafting is. Well, looky here, sir. I have, those are the items I have? Items can be assigned to certain keys. Press and hold the key to use the item. Oh, on the D-pad. Oh, that's how you do it. Oh, no, well, that one. set to that one. To that one. There we go. Nice. Okay, item compound creating. I have a lot of stuff. Oh, what is, I don't know what any of this shit does. Three reds for another giant lollipop. Okay, so the big ones are giants and the small ones are the teeny babies. I wish I knew what the witch's recipes look like. Cute little recipe list. That's adorable. It's totes adorbs. Alright, I don't think I need... I'm not going to build anything yet. I don't know if I need to do that. All that biz. How much money do I got? Back is how I check my monies. How do I check my monies? I need to check monies. Pressing start doesn't do it. I guess we'll just go down there and check my monies. I wasn't paying attention after killing all those angels. So I should probably...
And Angelic Kim's gold LP. Got your hands on something awfully rare, haven't you? That thing is the perfect bait to coax out some of hell's uglies. One note hits their ears, and a damn who's who of Inferno comes pouring out of the inner circles. Then I can use them to breathe life into what I make best. Weapons of mass destruction. Tell you what. You give me that record, and I'll order up something so fiendish, angels will cry at the sight of it. I'll just have to pop down to the tropics for a bit. So take a load off.
Excuse me, what? And goodbye to you, sir. Wow, this song is very nice. Delightful indeed. Oh, man, he back.
All done. He's a little rude, but he makes up for it with charm. Be nice to him, okay?
What? Did you just make shotguns? What? I have to pay for them still? What? Those are so expensive. The production version of the original Onyx Roses. Oh my god. God, those are amazing, but I can't afford them. Well, shit. I have 17. Yeah, not enough for nothing. Well, I guess at least he was able to make some things. That's... Oh, I stole my axe with me. I stole this axe. That's hilarious. Alright, let's get on out of here. What's going on? Oh, you again! Hey there, buddy. Oh, shit. Get your hand off of it. Get your hand off the damn thing. You're like cutting my combo out, and it's really getting annoying. Jump. Okay. Oh, damn, that was a good picture. Okay. I guess goodbye to that guy. I guess I wasn't strong enough to defeat him, or if I was, it probably would have cut me out of the cutscene thing. But that's fine. I lost my axe. It's a sad day. I miss that axe. Oh, shit, he's back! What the fuck? We gonna fight? Oh god. Oh, we're knocking your hands off. Time to knock your hands off. Ow, shit. Ow, shit. Where are you going? You're breaking. Too late. Damn! It's time to get going. Oh, right. Get out of here, fool! Oh god, am I eating him again? Whoa, damn him! He's like, no, please! Ooh, slapped his hand! He's trying to touch her butt. Yeah, boy! Oh, damn, that's just nasty. And he's literally just eating him whole. Wow, you are a hungry mess of hair. Ooh, oh, damn. Well, the best I could get. Sorry, I took damage a couple times. That was my bad. Yeah, I suck. The Angel's Metropolis, Chapter 1. I missed two areas, apparently. Uh-oh, that's not good. How'd I miss two areas? No item. That's poop. Oh well, I tried my best. Oh, nice. I missed Angel Attack. Let's do it again. Oh, that wasn't a good shot. Oh, what? I'm doing terrible on this. Probably easier with the mouse and keyboard, honestly. Let's see. Nope. Got him. There we go. Yeah, mouse and keyboard's a little bit easier for that one. Might have to start doing that. 48 points. Well, I can kind of build... What does this magic flute do? Magical flute said to have been played by the mythical sea beasts known as sirens, causes heavy damage to any nearby angels. Okay, that's what that does. Yeah, just exchange that shit. I'd rather get the money right now, because I want to get those shatties. Those nice little shotguns look. Sweet beans. Oop. I've been moved over to the holy city of Vigrid. Vigrid. All right. Chapter 1, Vigrid, City of Deja Vu. Or Chapter 2, City of Deja Vu. Oh, I can just go to Gates of Hell first. Cool. Well, let's go ahead and save. And I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you'd like to see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst Bayonetta player I've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and...